What's good, y'all? It's your boy Ross back at again with another video. So, with the response of my last video I posted, basically talking about Goldberg coming back to the WWE and challenging Drew McIntyre for the WWE Championship, inspired me to make this video. This is straight off the cuff, no script, just kind of first thoughts that come to my head. And it's the state of the WWE, man. Specifically the main roster. I'm not gonna lie to you, bro. WWE hasn't been as exciting for me as it has been in the past, in my honest opinion. Of course, you could probably chalk it up to the COVID situation and fans not being allowed to really be at any of the events and shows. I get that. That kind of takes down the overall experience, but it really comes down to the booking, bro. For the likes of me, it doesn't make sense why we should even have a Legends Night. Not to say that we can't show respect to the Legends, but I think we've done this so many times. I mean, we have one like at least once or twice a year, and they only pull out the Legends when the ratings are low. I feel like that's just a slap in the face to the up-and-coming wrestlers, bro. How many wrestlers have we seen come from NXT just to be poorly utilized on the main roster? There's no doubt about it that today's roster is probably the most talented WWE has ever had, and yet they barely use any of their roster. And if they do use them, they use them in poor ways, man. Like, I'm sorry, but having the Legends there just to be belittled and not really utilized, not really putting over the new talent, doesn't help anybody. You're just riding the nostalgia train. And I think the problem with WWE right now, main roster wise as a whole, is they don't know what their fans want. And the thing is, the fans make it very clear who they want to see, but no one cares. And it's not even, I don't even want to just pin, like, put the blame on everybody. We all know what the issue is. It's Vince. Vince is out of touch with the product. He's been out of touch with the product for years. The only person that really has some idea of what the fans want and what they're trying to see is Triple H. That's why NXT has been some of the best stuff on television. Even NXT has gone down in quality, but it's still much better than Raw. And SmackDown is still much better than Raw, only by really one main overarching storyline, which is Roman Reigns turning heel. I'll get to that in a minute. But Vince really doesn't know what the fans want in 2020 or in 2021. He hasn't known what the fans really wanted for years. We let it be known what we want, but he pushes who he wants. I never understood why you would have a team full of writers that probably come up with some great ideas that never see the light of day. I never understood that, to be honest with you. Like, I don't even understand how you don't allow your wrestlers, your talent, to input on their storylines and to input on, like, their promos and what their character would do. Some of them get that at that type of exclusive treatment, but not everybody. And I think if you want to build up someone's promo skills or build up their character, you let them kind of work with the writers and kind of give their own thoughts and feedback to make the overall show a better show. And it's like, what's the point of having all these people, writers and all these executive producers on the payroll when Vince is going to ultimately say okay, not okay, and he'll change up last minute stuff right before the show? There's been many reports where literally right before the show he flips the script. Oh, let's go this way, and it ultimately a lot of times doesn't work out. So I'm just really kind of confused on how they expect people to care. Now I get it, they're making a lot of money, so I think that's the bottom dollar here, making as much money as possible, and they're making some money, but I feel like they could be making more if they really just gave what the fans want. And you can also say, well, the fans don't know what they want. Sometimes it's true, we don't know what we want. But this wrestling has always been how the fans react. If the fans react to you positively, 9 times out of 10, you're going to be the next guy up or the next woman up. If they're reacting to you negatively, we got to do a character change. We got to roll with them not liking you. And that's what made wrestling pure. It's not like any other sports entertainment show. The fans kind of decide who's up next. And it's just one of those situations where it's like WWE has lost touch with their fans. They've lost touch with the time that they're in. Like, I'm sorry, Legends Night shouldn't have happened. Just being honest with you. Legends Night shouldn't happen at any point. Maybe if there's like a special event, sure. But it shouldn't be, you shouldn't pull out the Legends just to get a ratings boost. Utilize your talent. That is the downfall of the WWE. They just don't utilize their talent. And the writing sucks. And their logic doesn't make sense. Like, there's so many things that they could do, but they don't. Because ultimately, even though AEW is their competition, AEW isn't making much of a dent in their overall like viewership. Now, it won't. Now, I'm not saying that AEW can't. I haven't really watched too much AEW, but from the consensus of people that do watch it, they enjoy it a lot more than Monday Night Raw. Facts. And Monday Night Raw is supposed to be a flagship show. They enjoy AEW more because obviously they're getting what they want from the product. It seems like Tony Khan listens to the fans and knows what the fans want. So it's one of those type of things where it's like, you can't beat that. Why watch a product that they're not going to listen to me? They're not going to push the people I want to see, or they're going to just make some convoluted storyline, or we're going to watch the same match we've been watching for, I don't know, weeks now. How many times have you turned on Raw and seen the same match you saw the previous week and then immediately just turn it off because you don't want to see that? Gets boring. It gets very boring. It gets very redundant. They do the same stuff. It's like between pay-per-views, they just go on autopilot, and it's dull. And that's why they lose viewership. Now, let's get into Roman Reigns and why SmackDown has become the best version of WWE right now. And it's really because of Roman Reigns. Imagine if Vince would have listened to the fan reaction and turned him heel years ago. Imagine what type of character we would have now with Roman Reigns. You could have easily turned him back face. Imagine turning him heel when he beat Undertaker at WrestleMania. Imagine the type of nuclear heat, real heat, not we don't want to see you on TV heat, we would have gotten from him. And it's like, you listen to the fans now when there's no crowd, there's really no L in taking a risk. And it's like, that's cool. But even then, SmackDown is only being saved by one aspect. What about the rest of the roster? There's some interesting things going on here and there, but it's a lot of filler. And that's not enough to keep people wanting to watch. You know, eventually you're going to have something else to, you know, add to SmackDown. Because right now, it's just Roman. Roman is making SmackDown watchable. You know what I'm saying? So, and it all comes down to, once again, this is Vince McMahon's guy. This is the guy that Vince has been pushing for many years. And now he's finally getting this type of praise that Vince has been wanting. But it's like, you could have gotten that years ago. Now, I'm not complaining that he is heel. I'm really showing the facts that WWE, they don't listen. Well, I don't want to say WWE. Vince doesn't listen. He does what he wants when he wants. And that's what it comes down to. He will never change. That's just it. That's just what it is. And I think the only time he'll really just change is when people really just truly stop watching. Because I'm going to be honest with you guys, I only watch the YouTube clips because they're easy to digest, quick, straight to the point. I don't have to watch a whole bunch of fillers. I don't. I literally watch YouTube clips. I don't even watch Raw clips like that. The only reason why I watched the Oldbergs segment is because you guys wanted me to check it out. But I barely watch Raw segments. I only watch the Roman Reigns segments. I know you guys be like, damn, you only care about Roman Reigns? That's the only thing I really care about on the show. I'm sorry. They haven't utilized anybody else to the capacity of wanting to check it out. I check out the pay-per-views. And even with the pay-per-views, if you guys know, I don't check out all the matches. Because I don't care for all the matches. I'm just being honest. at least with NXT, I can at least digest majority of the matches that are on a NXT TakeOver card. So, I don't know. Will WWE ever change? Unfortunately, not for the foreseeable future. As long as Vince McMahon is running things, expect more or less the same. Like, there's a reason why you have people like Tommaso Ciampa saying they don't want to go to the main roster. And I understand why. Because they will never really get utilized correctly. I'm just being honest with you. Like, honestly, if you're in NXT, you should not aspire to be in the main on the main roster until Vince McMahon steps down. And we all know Vince is not stepping down. So he's going to be in that position until he passes away. Anybody can tell you that. Or he can't physically do the day-to-day duties. And I'm not wishing death upon the guy. I would never wish death upon anybody. You know, he loves doing what he does. So I'm not mad at that. I just think he's lost so much touch with how wrestling should really operate nowadays. It's a different time period. It's not the 80s anymore. It's not the 90s anymore. It's not the early 2000s. You gotta move differently. You gotta really be in tune with what people are wanting in social media. You know, they always promote Twitter and all this other stuff, but you don't even check out what the fans be wanting. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's simple. The blueprint is there. Listen to the fans. You know, not all the time, because not every time the fans are right, but majority of the fans, you know what I'm saying, know what they want to see. So if you're able to at least meet them halfway, people are going to want to watch the shows because, like, oh, damn, they're finally pushing this guy. Oh, damn, he's finally getting a title opportunity. Oh, damn, I've never seen this type of matchup before. This is new. This is fresh. Why not? You did it with Roman. You can do it with the rest of the roster. You just got to want to. So, comment down below. Let me know. What's your opinions on the state of WWE? Do you think it'll get better? Or do you think it's going to more or less be the same for the rest of 2021? Hopefully, it does get better. But my money would be definitely bet on the other half of it. More or less, will probably be the same as it was last year. So, it sucks to, you know, think that WWE is not going to get better. But hey, when it comes to Vince McMahon setting up Legends Night, it's not a good sign for the rest of the year for WWE. But who knows? It may be something better just right around the corner, hopefully. So I appreciate all the love and support. Road to 40K. Appreciate y'all kicking with me. I'll see y'all on the next one. Peace.